A very valuable tool in the install of the BrightLink is the Epson online throw distance calculator. The throw distance calculator is hosted on the Projector support page at Epson.com. To access it, go to Epson.com, go to Support, Projectors, and click on it. Then scroll to the bottom of the support page where you will find the calculator. Click on it. When the distance calculator appears on the left side of the screen, select Calculate. This will open the calculator. Once the calculator is open, you go to the top and type in the model number of the projector you are installing. In this case, I am using a BrightLink 725WI. After I type in the model, the projector shows in the model name field. Next, I go down to the basic settings menu where I put in information related to my install. I can choose how to mount the projector, on the wall, on the ceiling, or desktop. For BrightLink, I always recommend you use the Epson Ultra Short Throw Wall Mount. If you're projecting on a whiteboard, you can select whiteboard from the settings, and the calculator will account for the size and thickness of the board. You can select if the interactive function is on or off, and you can also select if there is a finger touch module as part of the installation. Next, you will find information about the image size and aspect ratio. The BrightLink 725WI is a native WXGA projector with an aspect ratio of 16 by 10. The native aspect ratio of the projector will always appear first. If you're not sure, you can refer to the information in the model name box at the top of the calculator. My image size is measured diagonally at 100 inches. If you wish, you can choose the image height and width based on the board size, and the diagonal distance will be calculated for you once you select the correct width or height. In the screen size window, there is a sliding button that allows me to adjust the image size, larger or smaller. As I slide it, you may have noticed the image area shown on the right side of the calculator increases and decreases as you slide the button. Next, I will select feet and decimal as my unit of measure. I can also key in the image size I want rather than using the slider. Again, when I key it in, the image size on the right side of the calculator changes. I now have a 100-inch diagonal image displayed. Next, I can determine the location which to place the mount, which also changes where the image appears. As I move the mount up and down, so goes the image area. In a similar way, I can adjust the projector to be closer or further from the wall. As I move the projector in and out, the image size changes. Over on the left side, the image size has also changed and now shows at 112 inches. To return to the desired size, I key in 100 inches. You can also set the height of the image relative to the floor. This is important in a classroom, and you should consider the height of the users when installing BrightLink. In this case, I will set the bottom of the image to be 3 feet from the floor. The calculator also tells the installer where the mount will go relative to the top of the image and the ceiling. You can also see the distance between the top of the wall mount and the ceiling, the height of the wall plate, which of course is fixed, and lastly, you can see the distance from the top of the image area to the ceiling. And with that, you are good to go on starting your installation. You can also print out the calculations once you have run the simulation on the calculator, which will allow you to reference it once you have begun to work.